Good morning all. So last class we have discussed about identification problems and digital signature. So by that in first unit half of the part will be completed. So now we have remaining topics left in first unit is, so we have mathematical basics. So mathematical basics, so in that we need to discuss about basics of computational number theory, where we have learned the number theory in our earlier classes like 10th intermediate. There we have learned about the number theory. So same mathematical things we will learn here for a cryptography purpose. And we have elliptic curve, elliptic curves, and pairing functions. Pairing functions. So if you complete all these three topics, then we have completed the first unit. So first we'll talk about the mathematical basics. So before going to this, so in cryptography, so majorly we use one of the algorithm, so that is RSA, so RSA crypto system, RSA crypto system, or you can call it as encryption. Encryption system, or you can call it as encryption system. So you can call this RSA, full form of RSA is Rivest Shamir Adelman. So Rivest Shamir Adelman. So three authors has developed this RSA crypto systems. That's why they have named it as RSA. So R means Rivest, S means Shamir, A means Adelman. So in the year 1977, they have developed this. So what is the main thing here is, before going to this, first we need to know about the public key encryption. Before going to the RSA, we need to know about public key encryption. So we have studied this in the previous classes. If you have any doubts, you can go to the previous classes. Okay, see here in public key encryption, so there is a alias, and there is another person called Bob. So two persons are there, so both are having their own public keys and public key. So you can call this as PK as public key of Bob. So suffix B means Bob, and we have secret key of Bob. Public key, it is a private key, you can call it as a secret key. Okay, so in alias also having public key, alias public key and secret key also there for the alias. Okay, in public key encryption, so both are having public keys as well as a secret keys. Okay, if alias wants to communicate to Bob, okay, so here alias wants to see the directory, there will be a directory here. In this directory, we are storing public keys of Bob, alias, and all the users. So in this directory, we'll have storing of all the public keys, only public keys are stored. So if he wants to send to the Bob, first he need to see the directory. Inside directory, if you have a Bob's public key. So using this public key, okay, first you will check in the directory. If Bob is having a public key, so using this public key, okay, so here we are going to encrypt the original message, whatever he wants to send, LS wants to send, it will be encrypted using public key of Bob, using public key of Bob. Okay, and then this original message was encrypted with public key of Bob. Okay, so it was encrypted. Now this message, encrypted message, is transferring to the Bob. Is transferring to the Bob. So after seeing this message, Bob sees the message and decrypts using his secret key. He is decrypting the message. So whose secret key? So his own secret key. It was not known to other persons. His own secret key. He is decrypting the message, encrypted message, and seeing the original message. So it is called public key encryption. So here Alas is looking into the directory and sees that Bob's public key. Using this public key, the original message was decrypted. The original message was encrypted, and this encrypted message was sent to the Bob. Okay. So after seeing this message, he is decrypting this encrypted message using a secret key. And after decrypting, he is seeing the original message. Bob is seeing the original message. This is called public key encryption. Okay. In public key encryption, so I am called as PKE. So we can call this as public key encryption. So there is a key generator. We'll have a key generator. So where, see the outputs using public key, secret key, so all those things. And there is an encryption. So inputs message and public key outputs, you can call this encryption as cipher text. You can call this output as cipher text. So outputs, cipher text. So it is about the encryption. And decryption, inputs cipher text, and secret key is used to decrypt the cipher text to see the output message. Okay, so it is how it is performing. So public key encryption, we are using a key generator, encryption and decryption. In key generation, we have outputs PK and secret key, and encryption we have input message, and we are using a public key of Bob's and sending this message in the form of cipher text. Now in decryption, so cipher text is the input. Using a secret key, Bob will decrypt and sees the output as original message. It is happening here. Okay, now we'll see. So what is the key generation? If you have any doubts, you can ask. Is my voice clear? Respond in chat box. Is my voice clear? Is there any disturbances? Anyone in the chat box, please respond. Is my voice clear? Yeah, okay. So is it visible? So whatever I'm writing in white paper, is it visible? Okay, then. See, now we'll see first the thing, key generation. key generation. Now is it visible? Okay, so key generation. So here in key generation, so we need to choose two distinct prime numbers, two distinct prime numbers P and Q. For key generation, first we need to choose two distinct prime numbers P and Q. So PQ should be large. The values whatever you need to take should be large, and there should be random numbers of the same magnitude. Okay, so whatever the P and Q values, distinct prime numbers we are taking, it should be large and it should be random of same magnitude. We need to take of same magnitude, and in this we need to perform multiplication of these two prime numbers, n equal to PQ. We need to perform n equal to PQ. So by performing this, phi of n equal to, so we can call this as Euler's totent function. So use Euler's totent function phi of n. So here we are using Euler's totent function. So phi of n equal to p minus 1 into q minus 1. So you need to use this Euler's totent in key generation, where n equal to pq. So you need to perform Euler's totent function, and we need to choose e belongs to z power star phi of n. So here we need to compute d equal to e power minus 1 mod phi of n. Now we will get public key equal to n comma e and secret key equal to d. So public key is used for encryption and secret key used for decryption. So here, so we can call this as primality testing. So we can call this as primality testing. First we need to take two values P and Q, distinct prime, which should be large, random, and the same magnitude, using the same magnitude. We can call this as primality testing. So here n equal to PQ and Euler's totent, it is used for fast multiplication of large integers. So for performing fast multiplication on large integers, we need to use this formula, Euler's totent function, n equal to pq, where phi of n equal to p minus 1 into q minus 1. And this function, we need to choose this for extended Euclidean algorithm extended Euclidean algorithm. So by observing all these things, we can get public key and secret key. So n comma e and decryption. Okay. So it is called key generation. So here we need to perform all these things for key generation in cryptography. So we need to know about mathematical basics for generating this key generation, encryption, and all those things. Decryption, all these things will be with the help of mathematics only. Okay. So these formulas we need to by heart. These formulas we need to by heart. So in number theory, I will explain all these things again. If you have any doubts, you can ask now in key generation. So next, we'll move to encryption. We'll move to encryption. If you have any doubts, you can ask up to now. If you have no doubts, keep no in chat box. See the question carefully. An attack in which the site is not capable of answering valid request. So here, the options are smurfing, denial of service, email bombing, ping storm. So four options they have given. So I'm giving some example for this. So later decide which is the correct answer. Okay. So here there is a server and there is a client. Okay. So client wants to request a server about some page. So meanwhile, some other client, so he is a hacker, he is continuously sending messages to the server to deny the request from the client. So what type of attack it is? What type of attack we can call this is? Continuously, the attacker is attacking the server by giving some requests. But the client was not able to send the request. He is always getting some error messages. So server is busy, these messages. So what type of attack we can call this as? Okay. So in polling, so poll your answer. So answer is B. So denial of service. Now we'll see about encryption. Now we'll see about encryption. So in encryption, so we need to know the message belongs to Zinfi N. So we can call this as Zinfi, that is 0 to infinity. So the values will be 0 to infinity. So these values will be used. Okay, Zinfi. And C for text. So we need to see C for text. Encryption is nothing but a C for text. C for text equal to message power encryption mod n. Message power encryption mod n. Okay, total message. So we can call this as fast modular exponentation. Fast modular exponentation. And call this as fast modular exponentation. Here, message belongs to Zinfi N. Message belongs to Zinfi N. Where C for text equal to message power encryption E and mod N. You can call this as fast modular expression. So it is used for encryption. This formula is used for encryption. And the same way for decryption. Same way for decryption. We need to use message equal to. Here they are using for decrypting. We need to use D. And from what we need to apply? For the C for text, we need to apply the decryption. So that is C for text, C, decrypt, D, and on. So where we need to perform this on mod, n, complete message. So we can call this as decryption. M equal to C for text of D mod n. In encryption, we can call M belongs to Z in V n. C for text equal to M power E mod n, where we can call as fast modular exponentation. Okay. So decryption means M equal to C for text D mod n. So these formulas are very important. So we need to by heart. And for so whatever the message it is encrypted, original message. So original message is there. First we are encrypting this thing, and then we are decrypting, and then we are reading original message. So we need to check correctness. So whatever the message we received, it is correct or not, we need to find out. That is called correctness. So from alas to Bob, have performing encryption, decryption, and then original message, and we need to see whether the message is correctness or not. For correctness, we have another formula. Correctness C power D, for text power D equal to message power encryption whole power decryption. So we need to perform. So this is correctness of decryption. So whatever you have performed correct, whether it is the message is correct or not, we need to perform. After decryption only, we will see the original message. That is correctness. Correctness power decryption equal to message power encryption decryption. That is equal to, you can call this as M power ED. We are writing directly M power ED. So that is equal to, you can write this as message power mod n. So message power mod n, you can write M power ED equal to message M mod n. So it is a formula for correctness. So here you have seen, you observe the last thing. So key generation, we are having output using a public key and secret key. Encryption is there. So here input is message, and using a public key, the output will be the cipher text. So we are giving a plain text using public key. Using public key of Bob, we are encrypting. So that means output is cipher text. Cipher text is the output here. Okay. So in decryption, we are taking as cipher text, that is encrypted text, we are taking as an input. Using secret key, we are decrypting to see the original message. It is encryption, it is decryption. Key generation means output, public key using secret key. Okay. So for key generation, we need to choose two distinct prime numbers, P and Q. So where P and Q are a large random of the same magnitude, we can call this as primality testing. And N equal to PQ, where pi of N equal to P minus 1, Q minus 1. It is a Euler-Stoland function. It is used for fast multiplication of large integers. And we need to choose E belongs to Z in P star pi of N. Compute D equal to E power minus 1 mod pi of N. So it is extended Euclidean algorithm where public key equal to N of E, N comma E. So we are encrypting this using a public key, and using secret key, we are decrypting the original message, SK equal to D. And in encryption, M belongs to pi, Z in P, N. C for text, equal to message power encryption mod n, so which is a fast modular exponentation, and decryption m equal to c for text mod n. And for finding the correctness of the message, we need to perform correctness of decryption equal to m power ed. You can write this as med. It is equal to m mod n. So likewise, we need to perform in the public key encryption. So these things are useful. Okay, so we may get 2 marks question on this. So how the encryption decryption correctness. Okay, so you need to remember this thing. We need to write all these things in 2 marks. Okay, we have any doubts you can ask in this public key encryption. Then we'll go for. So what are the security relays? Security relays on the following assumptions. Security relays on the following assumption. So okay, if you know this thing, then only we will move to the mathematical things. The basic concept is this one. If you know this thing, automatically go for the remaining topics. If you have any doubts, you can ask. And after this, I'm going to discuss about security relies, security relies on the following assumptions, okay, whatever you have discussed till now. So we need to see the security relays on this. First one is, it is hard to find decryption with given n comma e. So without secret key we cannot decrypt the message. If you have encryption performed on the message, so it is hard to find the decrypted message without having a secret key. Okay, so secret key is known to only a particular person. It is not shareable to all. So public key will be shareable. Okay, using the public key only we are decrypting. So see the Gmail, if you want to send a mail to other person, so here we need to write from your email ID to this person's mail ID, that we can call it as public key. That you can call it as public key. Okay, and there is a message. So if you transfer in an internet, automatically it is sending using some encryption scheme. It is sending. This is the ciphertext where we are transferring. Okay, so after reaching here, the message will be decrypted here. And now if a particular person who belongs to this public key, if he opens username and password, so username is a public key which is known to all. His username is known to all, that is @gmail.com, and this password is known only to the particular person. Okay, only this person can decrypt the message. If this is known to any other person, attacker, so he cannot see the original message because he doesn't have the secret key. Okay, it is hard to find the decrypted message. So with given n comma e. Okay, and second thing is, it is hard to find p comma q with given n. So with given n, we should not easily identify the prime factors. What are the values we have taken? The large numbers and random numbers, whatever you have taken, these factors will not be identified. These are integer factorization. So these are integer factorization. You can call this an integer factorization. With this number, we cannot get this thing. Suppose if we take an example. So I have given n equal to 20. Find PQ values. We see this example. So for getting 20, a p value may be 4 and q value may be 5. If you perform 4 into 5, you will get 20. Now there is second assumption, 5 into 4, 10 into 2, 2 into 10. So likewise, we are getting 4 things. It is not easy to identify whether what is a p and q. So by seeing n, If you know PQ, easily you can get N. If you know PQ, if you know N value, it is hard to find P and Q values because they will get so many values. So many values. Okay. So this is about public key encryption. If you have any doubts, you can ask. If you have any doubts, you can ask till now. See, respond in chat box. Do you have any doubts or not? If I have no doubts, means no. Keep no. If I have doubts, means yes. And ask the question. I will enable your mic. You can ask the question. So cryptography. See the question. Cryptography is the art of secret writing. Is it true or false? See the question is, cryptography is the art of secret writing. Is it true or false? Your answer. So cryptography is art of secret writing. So answer is true. So cryptography is art of secret writing. Okay. So it is about public key encryption. So now we'll go for the mathematics basics. So first we'll see. The topic modular arithmetic. So modular arithmetic. So before going to the modular arithmetic, we need to know about the arithmetics of integer. So before going to modular arithmetic, first we'll discuss about arithmetic of integers. So before going to the modular arithmetic, first we'll discuss about arithmetic of integers, arithmetic of integers. This means you need to learn about basic arithmetic, basic arithmetic on big integers. So basic arithmetic on big integer values. So big integers. So in arithmetics of integers, we'll know about the basic arithmetic on big integers. So how to solve big integers exactly? First, we need to know about how to solve bigger integers. Exactly. How to solve bigger integers exactly? See, first we need to represent. First we need to represent in some predetermined predetermined base B. First, we need to represent in some predefined base B. Store BRI digits. Store BRI digits in an array. In an array of built-in integers. First, we need to store array BRI digits in an array of built-in integers. So choice of b power of 2 and as large as possible. Okay, so here we can call this tree as multi precision. So multi precision integers, you can call this as multi precision integers. So first we need to know about how to solve bigger integers exactly. So for this, first we need to represent in some predetermined base B and store BRI digits. So we need to store BRI digits in an array of built-in integers, in an array of built-in integers. And third thing, choice of B power of 2 as large as possible. So we need to take B power 2 as long as possible. Suppose example for this is 2 power 32, or we can take 2 power 64. So likewise, you can take bigger integers. So here, n equal to number in base B, n equal to number in base B, that means n equal to n base B minus 1, comma, n base B minus 2, comma, and so on, n1, n0, with base B. So we can write this as sigma 0 to B minus 1, where ni bi, here ni B power I. So using this, we can calculate the basic arithmetic on big integers. Using this formula, you can calculate the basic arithmetic of big integers. So here these formulas are very important. You have to by heart this. So in upcoming class also, so many algorithms, so many formulas will come. Because we will deal cryptography with the help of mathematics. Okay. So if you have any doubts, you can ask in arithmetic of integers. Okay. Now, for performing conversion to decimal to base B, for performing conversion from decimal to base B, so decimal value to base B, so we have D0, D1 and so on up to D E minus 1. So it belongs to N S minus 1, N S minus 2 and so on N1, N0 with base B. With base B. So for percentile to base B, so you take the decimal values D0, D1, and so on, D minus 1. So, and here we need to take N S minus 1, N S minus 2 up to N1, N0. N1 and not up to base B. So this is the conversion formula for this multiplication integers, where to convert so decimal to base B, decimal to base B. See one more question in chat box. So which of the following cannot be chosen as a key in the Caesar cipher? Which of the following cannot be chosen as a key in the Caesar cipher? A, integer, B, alphabet, C, string, D, none of the above. A is integer, B, alphabet, C, string, D, none of the above. So which cannot be chosen as a key in the cipher text? Caesar cipher. So answer this question. So answer is C, string. You cannot take C, string as a key. So you can take integers, alphabets, all those things, but you cannot choose a string as a key in the Caesar cipher. So answer is C. Answer is C. Yeah, so answer is C. Now, we'll close this arithmetic of integers. Here, so we have seen the multiple precision integers where n equal to ns minus 1, ns minus 2, and so on, n1, n0 with base b. And we can write this as sigma 0 to s minus 1 ni b power I. So the conversion for this basic arithmetic on big integers is, so decimal to base b is d naught and so on dt minus 1, that is ns minus 1, ns minus 2, and so on up to n1, n0 base b. You can take this as n. Suppose we take this as n, then if the values of d is 0 to 10, suppose assume that g is 0 to 10, then we can write this as n equal to 10n plus dt. We need to write this for the arithmetic decimal to base equation. And for n dash, with base b, for finding out the n dash for base b up to d0 to dt minus 1 dt up to dt, so we need to find out n dash with base b equal to 10 base b into n base b plus dt, decimal value is up to t with base b. So here this two is a single digit BRA numbers, where if you take k digits at a time, then you can write it as 10 power k less than b. So that means, so if you write d0, d0, d1, and so on, dk t minus 1, and dk 1 minus n minus 1. So up to this, we can call this as n, and up to this, we can call this as n dash. Now we can perform the formula for based upon this. N dash equal to 10 power k base b. You can write this as 10 power k base b into n base b plus dkt and so on dk n minus 1 plus 1 base b. So it is the final formula for this. Okay, so base b means equals to base b dash. You can write this as b dash equal to 10 power l, where 10 power l less than b less than 10 power l plus 1. Start. So we can write this as b equal to hb dash plus l, where h comma l belongs to 0 comma 1 comma and so on b power 1 minus 1. Now n equal to n s minus 1 comma and so on n naught with base b, and n1 equal to ns minus 1 and so on n1, where n base s equal to 0 and n0 equal to n. So we will compute base B1, base B1, B dash, representation of n s minus 1, n s minus 2, and so on, n naught tentatively. So you can plus tentatively. So you can calculate this thing using this conversion. So decimal to binary. Okay. So up to this, I've seen about the arithmetic basic concept. If you have any doubts, you can ask this arithmetic of integers. In next class, we will discuss about the next topic, the modular arithmetic. Okay, then thank you.